wait, let's just save it first. I don't wanna screw up again.
Save new game.
Yes. Anyhow. Saved, and now let's do this.
A loud hissing fills the room.
Really? God damn it. Okay, let's try this again.
The vent is now open. It leads to the lower deck.
Oh, so that's how. Yeah, now it all makes sense.
With a hiss, the Romulan laughing gas billows down the vent. You hear the muffled sounds through the vent of hearty Romulan laughter, followed by the dull thud of bodies hitting the deck.
Fascinating. I'm experiencing an urge to laugh.
Amusing. Right, now we go downstairs. Oh, come on, go downstairs. Really? Come on, go downstairs.
Jim, is this how you feel?
Yeah, very fine, Spock. Come on, downstairs. I hate you, Jim. I really hate you.
I am a Vulcan. I must resist these unchecked emotions.
Come on, how?
You fail to obtain...
I remember my mother trying to tell me jokes when I was a child. Now, I finally understand them.
Yeah, it's worth not knowing exactly what to do just to hear Spock say shit like that. Yeah, funny. Come on, just go freaking down. Really? Really? Oh, come on. How the hell do you use these, maybe? Freaking finally. Okay, now let's just apply the cure to these Romulans.
The Romulans stir weakly, then begin to get up. They've all been cured.
They're severely dehydrated, but they'll live. We got to them in time.
Okay, then let's give them some water, yeah.
The Romulans drink thirstily and empty the container.
Take it easy now. You'll feel better in a few minutes. Good thing we had the water available, Jim.
We aren't barbarians, in spite of what some people think.
Yeah. Let's talk to them.
How many admirals does it take to wire in a logic transmogrifier?
Okay, then let's just go and free the captives.
The Romulan Preax stirs weakly, then begins to get up. He has been cured.
He's severely dehydrated, but he'll live.
Ah, screw him. Let's unbind them now.
Thank God it's you, Jim. I'm so glad you came.
I have called off the Romulan attack on this station, Kirk. I believed your virus was some kind of deliberate attack, but your great honor and compassion have convinced me otherwise.
You also conducted yourself in the most honorable fashion, Centurion Preax. You may return to Romulan space without Federation interference.
Screw you. No.
I assure you, the Federation would never undertake such a foul program. It was all an accident, right, Dr. Marcus? Save it for someone who's buying Preax. Leave Federation space immediately or we'll scatter your atoms across the quadrant.
Nah, not this.
You also... I assure you, the Federation would never undertake such a foul program. It was all an accident, right, Dr. Marcus?
Yeah, that's a little true.
You also conducted your...
You are an honorable adversary, Kirk. Jolon True.
You are also a worthy opponent, Preax. May you live long and prosper.
You'll never cease to amaze me, Jim.
Goodbye, Carol.
Goodbye, Jim.
Well, gentlemen, let's go home.
Yeah, that's...
Fascinating. I am experiencing an urge to laugh.
Well, of course you are, Spock. That's what you get.
Starfleet.
On screen, Lieutenant.
We have read your report on the problems at Arc 7 and evaluate your performance at 97%. You and your crew received 3 commendation points. The top brass at Starfleet are impressed. Outstanding work, Jim.
I wonder if I'll see Carol again.
Well, if you don't, you can always drown your sorrow in some Romulan ale.
That's illegal, Bones.
Tell that to the Romulans, Jim. I found the whole case they brought on board, the Arc 7.
They'll never replace Scotch, Captain.
That it won't, Mr. Scott.
And third ones.
Another fine mess.
Priority message from Starfleet.
On screen, Lieutenant.
We have reports of an undetermined number of Elasi pirate ships in your sector. You are ordered to proceed to the Harlequin Star System immediately and investigate. Starfleet out.
Oh, come on. Elasi again? Really? They just won't stop.
May I suggest we arm our weapons and raise shields now in case of trouble, Captain?
Yeah, sure. Raise shields.
Raising shields.
Thank you, Mr. Sulu. Mr. Chekhov, arm weapons.
Arming weapons.
Well, thank you.
I don't know how long she can take it, Captain.
Yeah, I know. Oh, let's use the computer a bit.
A Federation star system with 2 Class M worlds, both inhabited. Harlequin 3, Vardane, is an Earth colony that has been involved in controversy on more than one occasion. Harlequin 5, Aloysia, is a non-Federation world heavily influenced by Elasi pirates. Elasi 5. A binary star system, which one inhabited planet, Menalvagorn, is currently undergoing a revolution between factions which survive from raiding Federation ships and factions that wish to make peace with the Federation. Several continents were colonized centuries ago by the Andorian. The self-determination of the Menalvagorians and the treatment of minority Andorians is an issue of considerable controversy. The Elasi clan is the largest clan of pirates, and have been blamed for 46 attacks on Federation ships in the last 3 years. They use revolutionary zeal to mask their activities as pirates. Starfleet tactical analysis characterized them as being daring and impulsive, but skilled in analysis and planning. In effect, they are very capable of acting in an unorthodox and surprising manner when their plans begin to fall apart. They are considered a Class 1 threat to the Federation. Alassi Pirates. There are several bands of pirates based from Alassi Prime. The Aj Alassi family, the Aj Thuri, and the Andrasili. Recent events on Manalbagor have caused these bands, which typically battle each other, to unite and prey on Federation ships. Aj Alassi, meaning the Fist of Alassi, a name taken by the Demuri pirate clan of Manalbagor, and used as their surname for nearly 70 years.
Alright, interesting. So yeah, we're doing this now. Lots of interesting information, features, blah blah blah.
Romulans. A race descended from Vulcan stock, but one that did not reject aggression as the Vulcans did. On a sensor, the two races appear very similar. Their individuals are known for being more passionate and emotional than their Vulcan counterparts. They currently use ships of Klingon design, suggesting to some the Klingons are maintaining them as a client state to antagonize the Federation in a move that circumvents the Organian peace treaty.
Alright.
Federation. The United Federation of Planets, a body devoted to galactic peace and cultural and scientific advancement. Romulus. The name for the Romulan homeworld. Location unknown.
Topic not available, Captain.
McCoy. Leonard. Full name. Dr. Leonard McCoy. Current Chief Surgeon of the Federation Starship USS Enterprise. Dr. McCoy is considered one of the finest medical researchers in the Federation, but his techniques have caused him to be branded as a maverick in the medical community.
Interesting.
Death Grip. Vulcan. A Vulcan martial maneuver inspired by human fascination with proto-Vulcan hand-to-hand combat techniques. The Vulcan Death Grip has been depicted in several cinematic productions on ancient Vulcan. Though no actual Death Grip technique is known, the larger-than-life depiction of this hold has captured the imagination of many cultures, and even Klingons and Romulans believe that Vulcans practice this technique. Vulcans. One of the most prominent members of the Federation, a society devoted to logic and pacifism. The concepts of the Ibic and Gnome are only two of their contributions to philosophy. Famous Vulcans include Serac, Sarek, and T'Pau. Vulcan is also the residence of the human poet Virchow.
Alright.
Klingons. A humanoid life form that has used genetic manipulation to stratify their population. Their homeworld is Kling. Klingons' culture is based on the principle of survival of the fittest, either through guile or physical force. Principles of honor are used to prevent the culture from killing itself completely. But these principles are extended outside their species, only to non-Klingons who have proved themselves in battle. Negotiations over planets in the disputed area have been slowly advancing, hindered by recent Klingon technological exchanges with the Romulans. The Klingon Empire itself is economically backward and poorly organized, but their military force is extremely formidable.
Topic not available, Captain.
Sulu. Hikaru. Full name. Lieutenant Hikaru Sulu. Chief Helmsman of the USS Enterprise. Sulu is considered one of the most capable officers in Starfleet. had Cardinal graduated near the top of his class at the academy and is considered an excellent military tactician.